deeper lately. I like that, baby, 'cause I can't get enough.
Dice que no le es suficiente, está mal de la mente. Cuando está solita que entre, música para ponerla en ambiente, yeah. Ella quiere que coma aquella vez, ya. Le busco todo. Todo lo que se pone bonito se le ve. Empezamos a pie y ahora andamos en el jet. Vamos a calentar, baby, tú. No se quiere olvidar, lo quiere recordar, baby.
'Cause I can't get enough.
Yeah.
Yeah, I can't get enough.
Latino can.
Yeah, I can't get enough. I want that daily. Our breath getting deeper, deeper lately. I like that, baby. Yeah. Ooh, no one's gotta know. We can keep it low key. I'll be fine alone, long as you're alone with me.
Tell him.
So incredible, unforgettable on me. 'Cause
the NBA 2K community is like none other.
Yes, we've heard stories about how 2K has impacted people's lives and given them a platform to take their love of basketball off court.
It's really been amazing to see, and we want to recognize those that are doing good things in the NBA 2K community with a new series called My 2K Life.
First up, let's take a look at the man behind Poor Boy Sin.
The bustling city of Portland, Oregon. This is the backdrop for our broadcast setting tonight. Greetings and best wishes for a happy holiday season from all of us at 2K Sports as we get set for this NBA presentation. This is Kevin Harlan courtside with Greg Anthony and Clark Kellogg, and our reporter tonight on the sideline, David Aldridge. DA, it's all yours.
Blazers coach Terry Stotts had previous head coaching stints in Atlanta and Milwaukee, but it was as an assistant coach in Dallas, where he helped win the 2011 title, that he rejuvenated his career. Stotts wasn't sure he'd get another coaching opportunity, but after that, he said the stars aligned. Kevin, he's now in year 8 as head coach in Portland.
The players love him. Thank you, David. And let's check out a breakdown. Looking at some stats for Towns.
And he's gone dry over the past 10 games, guys. His scoring is way down, and he can't seem to fight his way out of the slump. He better get it going tonight, or they'll start losing patience with him.
And checking out Minnesota's opening lineup. Covington at the 4 with Towns in at the 5. Andrew Wiggins is out there with Culver. And it's Okogie in at the 3, the small forward. And for the Trailblazers, pairing up in the backcourt, Lillard and McCollum. Whiteside is out there with Anthony, and it's Bazemore at the small forward.
And one thing the Wolves have done well over the past few seasons, taking care of the ball.
Yeah, you know, they squeeze it well. Low turnovers can be a double-edged sword, though. If you don't make many mistakes, maybe you're not being aggressive enough.
McCollum, the stupendous finish in traffic. And here's Culver. Outside, Towns. Here's Covington. Good, and the assist goes to Towns.
I guess Towns got a little bit of point guard in him. The big fella with a beautiful dime right there.
Whiteside trying to break free, and they call the foul, so he's got the and-one chance here to make it a three-point play.
And the four-year, $196 million Supermax extension signed by Damian Lillard this offseason. Dame Dollar living up to one of his many nicknames, but money well spent by the Blazers.
One shot.
Mark, here we are in midseason, and certain teams seem to really change gear, ratchet up the intensity.
Yeah, I agree with you. And some of that is familiarity, understanding who you are and what it takes for you to win. And being healthy is a big part of that. I think teams all over the league go through stretches where they're in a nice groove and rhythm, and there are a lot of variables that play into that.
Things settle down, don't they? Rotations, routines, like you said, all those things important.
Yeah, exactly. Well said.
Misses from close range.
The defense ready for him on that possession. They had to be, because he is so strong in the paint.
They get it again. Culver. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul. That one's on Anthony.
And credit the aggressiveness there. I love it whenever Culver is looking to score. It focuses the defense on him and still able to get the job done.
And the first one at the line is good.
Yet another player from the 2019 draft class who wasn't a top high school recruit. Jared Culver, three-star guy, thin, unrefined. But in that sophomore year of college, boy, did he surprise some folks.
He hits both from the stripe. And, Greg, when you talk about Culver, the one thing he did show in high school and again showed at Texas Tech, the ability to score.
Yeah, and he creates and makes shots against great defenders. Every team in the NBA is looking for that. His jumper, his handle, his ability to move without the ball, already NBA-level stuff.
Banked in off the glass.
I'll tell you, Culver has an array of moves once he gets into the paint.
Here's Lillard, and they cash in right away with the quick shot. Lillard's got 9 points.
Strong start here early. Four of his first five made.
And Whiteside sends it back.
And Whiteside takes great pride in rejecting shots. Outstanding at getting his arms up and denying shooters.
Pass to Culver, launches a three, rebound by the Trailblazers. It's a victory here for the home team last time these guys met.
And they got the better of this matchup last time with their defensive pressure and the ability to force turnovers.
And that really was the difference. I mean, it requires a ton of energy to play that harassing style. It'll be interesting to see if they can do it again tonight.
Outside, Town. And there's the pass to Okogie. Good, and the assist goes to Towns.
And good to get him going early. That shot should give him some confidence.
Perhaps he's set for a big night. I mean, he can be a difference maker for him when he's on his game. Well, you got to be in awe of what he's doing this quarter, actually destroying the opponent.
Down low, here's Culver. Up and in, off to an efficient start, 2 for 3 from the field.
And how about the balance there from Culver? Really good at staying in control despite the D being all over.
Whiteside, good.
And hitting the mid-range jumper here early gives the defense just another thing to think about.
Well, they better be thinking about him. I mean, we know how dangerous he is.
And he might be small for a center, but boy, can he jump out of the building.
Lillard, and Lillard throws it down.
Boy, I love watching Lillard turn on the Jets using that astounding speed to blaze past the defender.
And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Damian Lillard. That's his first foul.
You know what? Tried to step in and cut him off, but just didn't get there quick enough.
Yeah, he was one step late that time, Greg.
So the Timberwolves called their first timeout. They're moving on after the tough loss they took at the hands of the Blazers.
You got to give them an A for effort. Just fell a little bit short in that one.
Yeah, they were really close right there. Just couldn't string together a few key plays to help get them over the top for the win.
Get a chance to check out the standings out west. Already we're in December. You take a look at the Trailblazers. Right now they've been able to gather the eighth best record in the conference as the latter part of the season approaches. And of course the Timberwolves, they find themselves in the dregs of the conference.
Well, right now for the Timberwolves, they talked all offseason about how this year was going to be different. Nobody bought into it then, and nobody's buying into it now.
Yeah, and it's too bad, really unfortunate, because I did think the potential was there. But at this stage, I think we've seen their best, and it's not going to be good enough this season.
And so it's Minnesota with it. Portland making their last shot. A shot by Culver, nobody around. And it's wide right, hits off the rim.
He's got to be disappointed with himself on that one. He has got to knock those down.
And again, it's Portland converting.
And the jump shot has been a dimension of this game where they've had a clear advantage.
Greg, they keep pulling up and watching them go down. It's a really nice thing to see.
Now here's Towns, providing around 26.5 points a game. Rarely has an off night. Lillard outside. And Damian Lillard with the jam.
Nice play, and you can see they're gathering momentum.
You know, they need to stay aggressive here. Build the lead up while they've got the chance. Don't waste this opportunity.
And the young Timberwolves head coach, Ryan Saunders, son of former Minnesota coach Flip Saunders, about as great of a pedigree you could ask for as a young coach.
Well, guys, you've heard me talk about the DNA when it relates to players. It's the same with coaches. I mean, Ryan has grown up seeing his dad coach at a high level, the late Flip Saunders, one of our favorites in the business. He spent his whole life around basketball, so he has a great way with players and a real good understanding of the game to a modern-day approach for a young coach.
And taking a quick look here, guys, at the hustle stats for the Trailblazers.
Boy, you have to admire their intensity in the paint defensively. I mean, really contesting and even blocking shots. Definitely a factor early.
And the other thing that's been equally as effective is the fact that they've gotten out on the fast break. A lot of points coming in transition.
Trailblazers leading by 9. Anthony finds McCollum over Wiggins. And there's McCollum. That's good on the assist by Anthony. Anthony's got 3 assists in the game. Timberwolves have gone 7 of 15 from the field to this point. Pass to Towns. Good work defensively by Whiteside.
The shooting numbers just aren't there yet in the quarter.
Goes up the baseline. Again, the Trailblazers score.
And usually teams go on runs, and it comes from a lot of layups and dunks, but not now.
Passes it to Culver.
Come get it.
In the corner, it's Wiggins. Here's Covington. That ball's nice feed that time from Wiggins. Covington's got his second basket of the night.
Oh, Covington really is fantastic at getting his arms high in the air when he's attempting a shot inside. Really gives the defense no chance to catch up to it or get to it.
I like their focus coming in. Terrific execution so far.
And you know, it's an all-out effort they've come in with. Very aggressive offense so far. Feels to me like this team is going to need more from him, guys. I mean, if they're to erase this deficit, he's got to step up.
Moving it around, 8 of their last 10 coming off assists.
And Greg, you know nothing makes a coach happier than selflessness on the basketball court.
And it's the Trailblazers on the break. Here's Lillard. That one rolling around and rims out. Timberwolves trail by 15. Kicks it to Culver from the arc. Doesn't get it to drop for him. So the Trailblazers will take it the other way. Back to Anthony. And it's Anthony with the jam.
And they have owned the paint so far, and the score reflects it.
And, you know, establishing that physical dominance early gives you a big mental edge, too. So don't discount that.
Little, he's checked in for the Trailblazers. And Fernie Simons comes in for Lillard. And the Timberwolves also making a change. Teague's checked in. Covington wide open. He fires. Scoring his third straight basket in 3 tries.
How about the alertness of Covington? I mean, sensing the separation from the defense and then cashing in on that space that was created.
Yeah, outstanding job there of taking the harm and still able to finish.
Yeah, he imposed his will on the defense that time. He was not going to be denied right there.
Here's what Portland's going with right now. Scal Labissiere's checked in for Whiteside.
Mind the lane.
And it's Tolliver in for Carmelo Anthony. A lot of players keep track of their stats, their own team stats. But, Clark, how much do guys pay attention to stats in-game?
I have no idea. I mean, I know stat sheets are given to the coaches during the timeouts throughout the game, but I don't think players in general are able to monitor their numbers. Now, there are exceptions to every rule. I imagine every team may have a player or two that can chart his numbers during the game, but the vast majority are too occupied with playing the game to keep up with the stats.
And they're looking up at the scoreboard too, aren't they? Because they give individual stats up on the boards.
Oh, man. Yeah, I tell you that, and then watching replays is one of my pet peeves with players. I mean, they should just focus on playing the game instead of always looking up to see if they fouled them.
And you know what? Very close to a 3-point play right there.
Yeah, he almost got that one down. I mean, those are the kind of aggressive plays coaches love to see.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
First one falls for him.
And you talk about shot makers. CJ McCollum, one of the best in the game. From mid-range, you could argue he's the best, flat out.
And so McCollum nails both of them. And you look at the shot chart for McCollum. He's a threat grade from everywhere.
Able to hit off the bounce, pulling up. At his height, he's got to be creative, making space for his shot.
Minnesota calls timeout. Clark, there are a lot of factors a free agent puts into selecting the new team that he goes to. Talk about the factors that aren't basketball for these free agents.
Well, I think you could see some of them if you gave it some thought, Kevin. You think about it, market size, nightlife for some guys is important. Business opportunities when you think about places like Silicon Valley or New York or Los Angeles. Season of life for the individual player in terms of his family and where he might want to reside after he's done playing. So there are a number of different things that contribute to free agents making moves from one team to the next.
Now, did you have a family, Clark, when you played your last couple years in the NBA?
We were without children, but it was Rosie and I. We've been married 4 years, and then our family started right after I retired.
And Let's take this moment to check out the point guards with the highest shooting percentage from the last 10 games. The fourth spot held by Jeff Teague.
As a point guard, you want to create the best possible shot every trip down the floor. And given the way these guys have shot the ball, you know, it's not a bad idea every now and then for them to go it alone.
Well, you know they're not going to do that, though. I mean, even as deadly as they are from the field, they're always looking to set up their teammates first.
Here is Tolliver after the basket by Minnesota.
This is as good as it gets for a first quarter in terms of shooting the basketball.
Greg, you're exactly right. I mean, everything seems to be dropping. Impressive scoring here.
Now, here's Napier.
What a jam!
Are you kidding me?
He is a highlight reel unto himself, guys.
That could be a contender for the dunk of the year, I think.
Without question, a crowd pleaser to the 10th degree.
They've been sensational on the backboard to start this game.
Yeah, sensational is a really good word for it, Greg. They're tearing it up on the glass. Tell you what, the defense was lucky there. I mean, leave him that open from range, he'll typically knock it down.
Simons, again, the Trailblazers, good for two.
Defensively, giving up far too many open rhythm looks.
And to battle back, they've got to shore up the defense. I mean, there's no other way to come back from a deficit unless you play good defense.
Teague for three. Rebound by the Trailblazers. Coming off that win against Minnesota.
And it was one of those games where it was just hard to get anything going. And you could see frustrations emerge.
And you know what? Even though it was a frustrating night shooting the ball, they found a way to get it done and pulled it out. And a win's a win. And that ultimately is all that matters.
And finished off by Jang.
Jeff Teague doing exactly what a point guard should do, setting up his guys nicely.
Portland leading by 20. And here's McCollum for three. And he's good on the three ball. McCollum's got his third basket of the night.
And he's not going to miss that sort of an opportunity from deep.
Here's Napier. And he can't answer back. The three-pointer offline. Shoots from the baseline. Again, the Trailblazers score.
And a lot of teams avoid the mid-range jumper, but they seem to be using it well.
I love that mid-range shot, Greg. It's definitely given the defender something extra to think about.
Just no resistance on the inside. That's their fifth consecutive make in the paint.
And, Greg, those looks they're allowing are almost automatic.
Give them credit. Offensively, they've been the more efficient team.
Well, you know, it's been all high-percentage shot for them so far. I mean, just the kind of execution you want in the first half.
Now here's Jang. He had a 15-point outing in their last game against Portland.
And off to a strong start offensively. He's got a nice touch.
Here's Little. First shot, first basket. He's out of the blocks fast.
Big miscommunication on defense. He recognizes it and quickly takes advantage.
Boy, the defense looks shell-shocked. I mean, they're on the ropes right now, on their heels.
And there is the foul. It's on Nasir Little. That's his first foul. Mario Hezonja has checked in for Scalabissier. There's 49 seconds left to play in the first. Graham with the bucket.
And they are attacking the rim and getting great results.
And how? I mean, they're taking this defense to task, taking them to school. Every one of their last 10 points have come in the paint. He's a big reason why they have the lead right now. He's made all of his field goal attempts thus far and remains hot from the floor.
Here's Napier. And that comes off the assist by Jeff Teague. Teague's got four assists in the game.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Yeah, and that's four straight field goals now, Greg, they've allowed from point blank range. Can't happen.
And so it's Teague with it. He'll bring it up for Minnesota. 2 second difference between shot clock and game clock. The three. It's hauled in by Tolliver. And now Portland on the break. Baseline J on the way. Again, the Trailblazers good for two.
This is why coaches talk about playing with pace. The scoreboard tells it all.
That really has been the difference. I mean, they've been the better team in transition.
And that's it for the first quarter in what's been a very lopsided game. Trailblazers out in front, running away with it. From Portland, we're back in a moment. One of the most high-powered scorers in the game, Karl-Anthony Towns, knows it's important to keep his teammates involved.
You know, everyone has to get some of the sugar, you know, so making sure you're not just being a ball hog. So I'm just always trying to make sure that I'm taking wide-open shots that I think everyone on the team would love for me to take if I have the opportunity. But also, at the end of the day, making sure everyone gets a chance to be in the candy shop.
Well, when you're attracting, Greg, all that defensive attention, it creates opportunities for your teammates.
And Towns wants to win big. To do that, though, it's not enough to get numbers. You've got to make your teammates better as well.
And if you're just tuning in, we've got a wide margin on the scoreboard, but plenty of time left for a comeback. And guys, the Trailblazers enjoying a nice lead here.
Just a terrific first quarter, sparked really by their unselfishness.
Yeah, and you know, so many of their hoops came off an assist, which is a good sign of ball movement and sharing that ball.
And now let's check out the lineups courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. Here's the second quarter of play. On the court right now for the Trailblazers. At the two and the three, McCollum and Little. Hezonja is out there with Anthony Tolliver, and it's Simons in at the one spot.
Nicely done. They continue to attack inside, and that's 10 points in a row in the paint.
If you can't stop it, here it comes. I'm right at you.
And they are earning points with the jump shot now.
Outside Teague. In the corner, Napier with it. That's good, and so Teague with the assist. Napier's got 7 points in the game. Here's McCollum. Rebound by Jang.
You're not going to see that very often. Plenty of space, but he just, let's face it, he whiffs on that one.
Good work there as it goes. 6 points for Jeff T.
And they're forcing the ball inside, and it's working like a charm.
The shot's good.
Major dominance, and it comes so easily for him. Fantastic at getting to his spots on the floor.
Quarter number two, we're about 2 minutes in, and the shot goes down. Napier's got 5 points in the quarter.
Well, we've seen that movie a few times, haven't we? An easy bucket in the paint.
Well, listless and lifeless at the defensive end. I mean, especially inside. They've really got to pick up that interior defense.
Pass to Teague. Here's Vonleh, and he banks in the layup. Vonleh's got his second basket of the game.
He got a little room at the rim and laid it in. Great play.
And last year, a tough one for Jeff Teague. Just couldn't put together his normal level of play.
You know, Teague missed some games with injury, but his shot just wasn't consistent. His passing and playmaking were as strong as ever, but you just couldn't rely on him to score.
Vonleh, the pass to Jang. Score of the basket is third after 5 shots.
And there's a pattern starting to take shape here. They're working it inside and getting good shots from close range.
Well, I agree with you. 4 of their last 5 baskets have been exactly of that variety.
And slams it home and gets some camper time on the end of it.
He did. He spent a while up on that rim, didn't he?
Yeah, you know, the refs are much more lenient with that kind of situation than they used to be.
Now, here's Vonleh. Defense is right there, and the dunk by Graham.
And we always talk about making your teammate better. That assist was right on target.
Here's Simon. Clark, what would your dream backcourt look like? If you were going to design one, what would it look like?
Well, they'd have good size and athleticism, somewhere in that 6'3 to 6'6 range, and the ability to make plays for themselves and others, and also be very solid at the defensive
take
end.
A break. Take
you know,
a break.
You think about some guys that would fit that bill. I look at a guy like Malcolm Brogdon. who really gives it to you in multiple ways as a backcourt player. And I like the scoring of Damian Lillard.
Agreed. And he makes the first. A different look now for Portland. Whiteside's checked in for Tolliver. Anthony comes in for Little. And it's Kent Bazemore in for McCollum. He doesn't get the second one. And Diggs at the ball here for the Timberwolves. Here's Okogie. Excellent D there from Anthony.
And he thought he had a clear path to the hoop, but the defense didn't give up on that play and cut him off.
A nice shot by Simons.
You know, maybe he's not one of the elite sharpshooters, but even still, that's not a shot the D can afford to give him.
From 10 feet out, Towns, no luck.
He is single-handedly dropping the temperature in here with that cold streak.
And he's got to find other ways to contribute then, because his shot-making is not happening right now.
Teague, the pass to Okogie. The Timberwolves working the ball around him. And Wiggins throws it down.
Well, I tell you what, he got major bounce, but the long arms, Kevin, of Wiggins gives him an extra advantage converting at the rack.
Now here's Teague. He had an 18-point outing in the last game against the Trailblazers in Portland.
And even while he was piling up all those points, he still found a way to create chances for his teammates. The assists just kept on coming.
And the foul on Carmelo Anthony. That's his third foul of the game.
And already his third foul. It's got to be time to get him out of there, probably until the third quarter.
The Trailblazers making a switch here. Lillard's checked in, and a change for the Timberwolves. Culver's checked in for Jeff Teague. And it's good, 2 points. That's now 8 points for Robert Covington.
And really keeping the ball hopping around here offensively.
The last 5 trips they've had have ended with a great pass leading to a basket. They're really sharing the sugar.
And how about Lillard just being aggressive here on offense? He can heat up quickly, just super efficient, and a high IQ score.
There's the pass to Wiggins. And that one's good. His second basket of 4, shooting 50%.
And the crisp passing has opened things up for them offensively.
10 straight points off assists. That's very impressive. And it also makes the game easy and fun to watch. Guys, I tell you what, feels like everything is coming easy to him. Just taking what he sees and capitalizing.
Here's Towns, and stolen by Whiteside. From the baseline. And good, as it just snugs right down through the net. Minnesota's gone 1-2 on 3-pointers here in the second quarter so far. Now, here's Culver. Covered by Lillard. Wiggins outside. From outside the arc. And it's Portland with the rebound. Whiteside's got 6 rebounds now in the game.
And a big lead for them on both the scoreboard and the backboard thus far.
Yeah, rebounding has been a big key in this one, Greg. They've asserted their will and have taken control on the glass.
The Trailblazers shooting their 7th free throw attempt here. And Portland making a change here. Labissiere's checked in.
Mind the lanes. Mind the lanes. 1 shot.
And you know, Carmelo Anthony is a special player, guys. A bulky small forward with a quick trigger release and elite score.
Here's Okogie, covered by Anthony. And he gets it to go as they call the foul. He's on his way to the line for 1 more.
They're finding lanes to the hoop now with consistency. 5 buckets in a row from the paint.
And on the flip side, Greg, the defenders have to show more fight on the interior. They've got to offer more resistance here.
So timeout called here, the first for Portland. And Clark, when you were playing, I imagine the pre-draft process was a lot different than it is today.
No doubt about it. I mean, I came out in 1982 after my junior year, Kevin, and at that time, if you were a guy who was declaring early, you basically just had to go on whatever knowledge and information you could get from whoever, because there was no allowing you. You weren't allowed to go to a workout. Teams could interview you, but there were no on-court workouts, so it was totally different than today.
Here's a peek now at the 2K leaderboard. This year, these teams have made the most of their offensive rebounds. Fifth, the Timberwolves.
One of the better rebounding teams in the league, especially on the offensive end. They never take that for granted in terms of whether the shot's going in.
Well, you've got to give a lot of credit to Josh Okogie. I mean, he was the 20th pick in the 2018 draft and really well ahead of the curve as a rookie and even saw starter minutes later on in the season. That's a great get for them.
Now, here's Culver. He's guarded closely. Towns, the pass to Culver. To the right side. For three, Okogie. The shot, no good. And it's Portland the other way. And meteoric rises, not uncommon for Okogie.
Yeah, and Okogie's done a really nice job kind of turning the impression of him around because he wasn't highly touted in college. But I tell you what, he's proven to be an impact player because of how he can defend and shoot.
Covington passes to Okogie. Culver with it. The three ball. Gets the three-pointer to fall. Culver's got 12 in the game.
Shooting off the catch is about confidence. There, Culver demonstrating how it's done.
Lillard with the bucket.
Boy, what a quarter for him. I mean, he's found his rhythm, and he's really riding that wave right now.
Culver passes to Okogie. Now, here's Culver, covered by Anthony. And then Culver with the dunk.
And Culver's been aggressive as well, and his shot is going down with consistency.
He has a chance now to catch up with the fourth member of our crew, Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Well, Kevin, last season the G League tested out an expansion of the clear path rule. Now that expansion is making its way to the NBA. It should discourage those intentional fouls that slow up teams on the fast break. Fans wanted it, and analysts clamored for it. That will allow the amazing athletes in this league more opportunities to show what they can do the fast break.
You're right, David. A welcome change. Thank you. Outside, Towns. And a miss there on the triple. Portland's gone 3 of 4 from long range in the game. Here's Bazemore. Wiggins with the block.
Great read that time by Wiggins, anticipating the shot. Sends it out with return to sender postage.
Shot from the inbound, and Damian Lillard with the bucket on the assist from Labissiere. Minnesota's gotten cold from deep in the second quarter, just 2 of 6 from long range. And Damian Lillard with the jam.
Boy, you have to respect the quickness of Lillard now because he's excellent at using his hands to complement those quick feet to come up with steals.
Left side, Covington. And Labissiere sends it back. And that's out of bounds. Minnesota will retain possession. Here's Towns. Pass to Okogie. Down to 5 on the shot clock. And once again off the mark by Minnesota. Passes to Lillard. A baseline J, and again, it's Portland converting.
No, it's scary because he's just been a matchup nightmare in this game. He's eaten up anybody they've thrown at him.
Now, here's Culver, covered by Lillard. Covington passes to Okogie. And, oh, he blocked it and deflects off the backboard. Here's Bazemore, and the slam dunk by Bazemore.
Offensively, defensively, they are in total control.
And don't leave out the coaching staff here now. I mean, their game plan has been perfect.
Each trip down becoming more important.
And you need to string some successful offensive possessions together and play tough deep.
The baseline J. They grab their own miss. Again, the Trailblazers good for two.
How frustrating for the defense. You get the stop, but then fail to block out.
Well, you know, that's the way it's going to be for them today, fellas. Can't sustain any momentum.
Here's Towns. No good, now shooting just 20% this game at 2 for 10.
Yeah, that's another miss for him. They're behind in this game largely because he shot so poorly.
Count it, good.
And love the muscle Anthony brings to the three spot. Takes pride in outworking everyone when he's that deep inside.
Pass to Okogie. The three, good, and the assist goes to Towns. Towns has got his fifth assist in this one.
And, you know, even though he's not a lights-out shooter from deep, the defense still has to be more aggressive there. He's certainly been their go-to guy when it matters most. He's trying to close this one out.
The Timberwolves shooting 52% from the floor. Nice work so far from them. Culver, and he makes good on the layup. Culver's got 18 points.
And that attacking mindset, when Culver sees an opportunity like that, he just grabs it.
And it's Lillard missing.
Yeah, he just flat-out tricked that one, missed it, and has no one to blame but himself.
Covington with the bucket.
Boy, he's really been dominant in this one. Unfortunately, he hasn't had much help.
Here's Lillard, and Damian Lillard with the jam.
Really like that work there in the paint. He has really established a low-post presence.
Minnesota shooting 59% here in the second quarter. They're playing with great confidence. And the call on the shot that sends him to the line.
And what makes Culver difficult to defend, it starts with the footwork and then the change of pace, and you give him that ability to just rise up and shoot over you.
The Timberwolves made three free throws so far, haven't missed any.
And as a team, really just middle of the pack in terms of their percentage from the line at about 76.
You know, their percentage has dropped off just a little bit compared to last year, guys, but it's not a huge drop-off, so no major concern.
That free throw missing.
And Culver's game just screams potential. Already a good scorer, rebounder, and passer. Now the next step, improving that outside shot.
Here's what Portland's going with right now. Anthony Tolliver. He's checked in for Whiteside. Little comes in for Carmelo Anthony. C.J. McCollum, he's checked in for Kent Bazemore. And it's Simons in for Lillard. So neither attempt will fall that time for him. Portland's gone 3 of 4 from long range in the game. And McCollum the bucket on the assist by Little. 21 points for C.J. McCollum. 26 seconds left in the second quarter. Culver dishes to Jang. The pass to Napier. Puts up a three. Rebound by the Trailblazers. Here's McCollum. And good. Got the friendly bounce off the right side of the rim. McCollum's got 8 points in the quarter.
And even with the big lead, he remains focused on the task at hand.
Yeah, and you know, that is some shaky and shoddy defensive work. They got to tighten it up.
And so it's Portland with a huge lead at the break. Safe to say there's no catching them today. From the field, they have been outstanding, amazing shooting. That's what has them headed to a blowout. It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks, Kevin. Andrew, they shot the lights out in the first half. What has to change? get back. You know, focus on getting back, guarding your man. And I'll take these real.
It starts with a man-on-man challenge. Thank you. Back to you, Kevin.
Thanks for the great interview, David. And we'll be back for the third quarter of basketball following halftime.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, welcome back to 2K Sports. Ernie Johnson alongside Shaquille O'Neal and the Jet, Kenny Smith. Let's get to it. Damian Lillard has been having a big night. He had a scoring performance for the ages, putting up an enormous amount of points and also three steals. There was a lot to like about his first two quarters in this one. What'd you think about Portland, Kenny?
One of the things Lillard gives you year after year is consistency. Look at his stats. They're almost the same across the board every season. And then he has nights like this where he takes it up a notch.
Shaq, what'd you think about Minnesota?
Well, they gave up too many good looks. Look at the field goal percentage against them. This tells the whole story. Not enough activity defensively. Not enough disruption, right? Like, Kenny disrupts me all the time. Not enough disruption.
And that'll do it for us. The third quarter about to begin with Kevin Harlan standing by. We'll catch you on the flip side.
My brother.
And as we dive into the second half, we'll find out if the next two quarters are any different from the first two. So far, it has been a runaway. Really an incredible game from Lillard.
No problems fighting his way to the rim in this one. A lot of points in close.
Yeah, you know what, guys? They gave him too many free runs to the hoop in the first half. I think they've got to be a lot tougher on him. Body him up. Be physical with him.
And with the second half upon us, we'll find out if this game becomes the route that it's threatening to be. Checking out the group now for Ryan Saunders to start the second half. Covington at the four with Towns in at the five. Culver out there with Andrew Wiggins, and it's Okogie in at the three spot. He made the only free throw attempt he had earlier in the game.
Taking two shots.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And that one misses. He's off on the second. Portland's gone 3 of 4 from long range in the game. Here's Lillard, and another one falls.
My goodness, 50 for the eight.
Yep, he is putting on a show. Culver passes to Towns. Wiggins outside. Nice ball movement by Minnesota. Shot clock at 6. Good, and the assist goes to Towns. Towns has got his 6th assist on the night.
Boy, the progression of Wiggins' game out beyond the arc. He now is not only shooting that shot, Kevin, he's expecting to make it.
You can't look at the result of that shot. They'll take that whenever they get it.
Well, you know, I hear you. That's a good look. But when you're that wide open, I think you got to knock it down.
And looking good there from distance. Culver fundamentally sound with his jumper. And you look at how Towns is so effective on offense, and it's because he really has the entire package for a big man. Back to the basket, facing up, playing outside or in, off the bounce or on the catch. This guy can do it all.
On a nice little roll here to start this half, connecting on their first 3 attempts.
Let's it go from the wing. Here's Whiteside. Drops in the layup for 2. Whiteside's got 4 this quarter.
And the presence of Whiteside in the paint, really unreal. He is a dominant figure down low. Great work to grab that second chance opportunity.
Towns wide open. No good on the 3. Yeah, Greg, as you said, it's the skill level of Towns at his young age that is so incredible.
very capable three-ball shooter, but he likes backing you down on the block as well. You step back and look at what he can do for a team, and there aren't really any holes in his game.
Okay, two hands for safety. That's what they say, right?
That's right. He was ultra safe with that dunk, no question.
And he should be. I mean, remove all doubt. Get it down hard and simply.
To the paint, here's Wiggins. Lays it up and banks it in. Wiggins has got 9 points.
How about the recognition from Culver? Terrific at realizing when the defense has broken down.
Here's Wiggins, and Wiggins throws it down.
And he can time his passes so perfectly. Wow, what an assist.
Time called here. The Blazers decide to talk it over.
Well, you know, it's not been easy for Andrew Wiggins the last few seasons, guys. The production has just fallen short of expectations. He was the number one pick back in his draft class and really has struggled to live up to what the fans have expected him to be.
With a quick break on the court, we've got some time to show you the list of the top rookie shot blockers over the course of the last month. Fifth best, Jarrett Culver.
He's been a factor on the inside. An impressive stretch for him defensively.
Well, he's been slapping shots out of there all last month. I mean, he's building a reputation as a guy you don't want to challenge inside. His arrow is definitely pointing north.
And with Wiggins, he's clearly a talented player, Clark, but people just want more from him.
Yeah, I agree with you, Kevin, and a lot of it is a matter of consistency. And when the expectations are high, being a former overall number one pick, that pressure can affect you. But I think if Wiggins can just lock into being consistent, all of that will subside.
Now Culver, he's got 23. Covington's shot is off.
Boy, they dodged one there, guys. I mean, he got the wide-open look that he wanted, just didn't knock it down.
And the basket by McCollum.
Yeah, you know, Lillard has been so good at finding the open man, puts a lot of zip on his passes, and he knows he's responsible for getting his teammates the ball.
Now, here's Culver. Defense right on him, and that one, good. Culver's got 25 points in the game.
How about that wonderful floater he has, showing off an exquisite touch.
And the three off target. Anthony with it, now Covington defending.
Tell you what, that is a missed opportunity from mid-range for sure. With as little defense as was shown, should have made that one.
To the inside, and it's in. Basket number 6 for him thus far. He has only missed 2 shots from the floor.
And we're seeing some great ball movement out of this group, guys.
Inside, Lillard. Rebounded by Covington. Minnesota's gone 2 of 5 with the 3-point shot since coming out of the break. And the basket by Okogie.
Man, I need to see some more assertiveness out of these defenders.
Trailblazers have gone 6 of 14 since halftime. A little cold from the field. Here's Lillard. Drains it from 17 feet out. Lillard's got 56 points in the game.
And he can score from all over the court. But Lillard at his best from mid-range. He deserves extra special attention from the defense in that in-between area. But sometimes, even then, that's not enough.
And a look at how the hustle game has been going for the Trailblazers.
Boy, their hounding, harassing effort at the defensive end, very impressive. And they forced quite a few turnovers as a result.
And also, I've been extremely impressed with their interior D. Their rim protection has been as good as it gets.
Ario Hezonja's checked in for Portland. And the Timberwolves also making a change. Graham's checked in. Time called here. The Blazers decide to talk it over.
Well, he might not be blocking four shots a game anymore, but Hassan Whiteside's still a factor in the paint defensively. Some numbers for Hassan Whiteside. He's been dominant over the last month, averaging about 16 points, 15 rebounds, and over 3.5 blocks. And his rebounding is what's most impressive. He's shown tremendous determination on the backboard.
And it's a big asset for this team. I mean, he blocks out on the defensive glass, and then he keeps balls alive at the offensive end.
And with Whiteside, his size and length set him apart from others defensively, Greg, even at the center position.
You just can't ignore the reach and coverage that Whiteside has when he's in the paint. Even though the block numbers aren't what they once were, the amount of shots he changes is still very high. And they've had assists now on their last three baskets.
Here's McCollum. He hits the back iron and sinks the shot. McCollum's got four this quarter.
A natural score. Give McCollum any room to get his shot off, and he's going to let it fly.
To the middle. Here's Wiggins. Good, and the assist goes to Towns. Towns has got his seventh assist of the game with that last one. Portland's gone 3 of 4 from long range in the game. Here's McCollum. Graham with the rebound. Minnesota's gone a less than productive 2 of 6 from three-point land in the second half. Culver's shot is off. And Whiteside's got the ball here for the Portland Trailblazers. It's McCollum with the drive. And he uses the glass on the layup. McCollum's got 29.
Man, he's having quite the quarter, converting at a really high percentage.
Pass to Wiggins. Down low. Here's Covington. It falls for his seventh bucket of the contest. He's 7 for 9.
Staying alert and aware, Wiggins sees his man flash to an open spot. Pass is right on the money.
Anthony. Whistle blows. Bucket is good. And he'll have a chance at the line to make it a three-point play.
Yeah, taking it right into the teeth of the defense. And it's a defense that's starting to look frustrated.
Well, they should be. I mean, it has not been a good performance for him at that end of the floor.
This trip is his second to the free throw line in this one. Here's what Portland's going with right now. Anthony Tolliver. He's checked in for C.J. McCollum. Little comes in for Hazania. And it's Simons in for Lillard. The Timberwolves also changing it up. Noah Vonleh comes in for Robert Covington. And it's Teague in for Culver. That free throw good from Anthony. Here's Teague. He has 6. On the wing, Wiggins. Here's the 3. No good that time. And it's Portland the other way. Following this one, they get to host the Pelicans. That'll be the final game of this 5-game homestand.
Well, you got to respect the jump shot of Anthony because he's got the ultimate green light. And because of that freedom, he's a dangerous guy on the perimeter.
Teague feeling it out a bit. Out left to the wing. Here's Towns. And that comes off the assist by Jeff Teague.
The assist.
Teague's got assist number 10 tonight with that last one. Whiteside kicks to Tolliver. Over Vonleh. And again, it's Portland converted.
You got to have a good basketball IQ to be effective. I love the decision to kick it out.
And for the Timberwolves, they're shooting the ball really well in this game. 58%. Towns dishes to Vonleh. It's hauled in by the Trailblazers. Whiteside's got rebound number 17, if you can believe that. And he floats in for the easy 2. Credit the assist on that one.
Anthony, a perennial all-star talent, specifically because of that scoring ability. One of the best in the business.
Back to Towns. And a wide open look here for Wiggins. Finds himself wide open and drills it. Wiggins has got 15.
And he has starting to turn it on now after that slow start.
Tolliver, no luck. Here's Graham. He's got 6. Wiggins outside. Shot clock reset for the Timberwolves. Towns with the bucket.
Well, I like the way Towns reads where the ball is coming off when it's missed. And he's got excellent timing as well and did a good job beating everybody to the ball.
And that one drops for him. Tolliver's got 4 this quarter.
Carmelo Anthony showing you his passing skill there.
Over to the wing. Here's Vonleh. And it's Whiteside with the rebound. Whiteside's got his 18th rebound here tonight, all over the place. Got that bucket in no time at all.
Obviously, a mix-up defensively on that possession.
Outside Teague to the middle. And Graham throws it down hard.
And I tell you what, guys, Teague is just not looking for his own shot. I mean, a dependable point guard who shares the rock well.
Offensive rebound, and it's slammed in by Whiteside.
Nothing soft about the putback there.
And why chance it, right? Take the dunk if you've got it.
Well, you know, if nobody's going to put a body on him, then that's going to be the result.
Towns, and the dunk by Towns.
Tremendous combination of power and finesse there. I mean, once Towns gets to the rim, it's a wrap.
And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here. Greg, let's take a look at Nasir Little. More power and athleticism at this point than skill, wouldn't you say?
I mean, no doubt. As an amateur, he could rely on the physical gifts to dominate. But in the NBA, you have to be able to shoot and handle with confidence. I think Little will get there because he has a tremendous work ethic.
The first one falls. Both teams will make substitutions. Both shots good from the stripe. Here's Napier. 9 points in the game so far. To the paint and finished off by Graham.
And you know, passes like that go a long way. Terrific teamwork.
Here's Little. It's rebounded by Towns. Towns has got 8 rebounds in this game. Here's Napier. A 3-pointer, no good. Portland's gone 0 of 2 from deep to start things here in the second half. Little can't hit. Minnesota shooting has been beyond great up until now. How about 57% from the field overall? Napier passes to Teague. And he gets the whistle. 2 free throws coming up. Gary Trent. Here now, the upcoming schedule for the Portland Trailblazers. On Monday, they'll be facing Drew Holiday and the New Orleans Pelicans. And then on Thursday, they'll face off against Donovan Mitchell and the Utah Jazz.
Take a break. And no secret that this team can be very tough in their own building. And that's good news as they are loaded up with home games over the next stretch. This is a chance to create some separation.
Free throw, good team.
And you know what I like most about Teague is his confidence. I mean, he's unflappable. He's cool and composed and yet plays the game with a real fire.
Jang, he's checked in for Towns. And so Teague gets 2 free throws. 1:25 left in the third. Here's Trent. The long distance 3 is buried.
How can you forget about him? I mean, he's not going to miss that open of a look.
Passes it to Teague. Jang with the ball. To the inside. Napier. It falls for his 5th field goal of the night. Now shooting 5 for 8.
Gorgui Dieng doing a nice job getting the ball to the open teammate there. Nicely done.
Here's Trent. That shot misses. Great D that time from T. In the corner, Napier with it. That shot, no good. Now Portland takes it the other way. Here's Trent. And he drops in the layup off the glass. Trent's got 5 points now in the quarter.
Sensational ball movement there. When you pass the ball like that, good things happen.
Teague finds Napier. It's in and good for his sixth field goal in 10 attempts. Here's Simons. He's got 15. Just 1 second between the shot clock and game clock, and it's Horde missing. And so Graham will bring it up for Minnesota. Inside, here's Vonleh. Count the bucket, coming off a perfectly placed assist. Vonleh's got 6.
A super high percentage shot there. You just can't allow him to get that close.
Count that one. 6 seconds left in the third quarter of the game. Just 3 on the clock, and the layup good by Teague. He's got 10.
Hey, even though the defense was lurking and Teague's not that big, he still has great confidence to score.
And so it's the Portland Trailblazers holding an unbelievable lead as the quarter wraps up. It seems like nothing they do can go wrong as they string together one successful possession after another and are simply running away with this one. Back to the action after this word. And a moment now as we take a look at our State Farm assists of the game.
And how about the big fella here showing us he's got some point guard skill here with the tremendous setup.
Hey, that was a high-level pass no matter what position it came from. But it does make it stand out a little more when it's made by the big fella.
And we reach the fourth quarter in a game that may be already out of hand. Brown out there with LeVissier. And it's Simons in at the point guard position. That's the group on the floor for Portland. Count that one.
And the combination of his quickness and soft touch around the rim really allows him to pull off shots like that. A lot of players don't have the reverse in their arsenal.
Pass to Napier. Portland grabs the miss. Here's Simons. And it's out of bounds to Portland. They'll retain possession. Hezonja is checked in for the Trailblazers.
Mario Hezonja.
Here's Trent. That one misses. The Timberwolves go the other way with it. There's the pass to Napier. Shot number 12 goes in. He's made 7 of 12 now.
And that's an example of playing big, adapting to the situation.
And sometimes that's the best policy when you're going up against a big guy. Take it to the 10, right at him. Get to the rack.
Portland again missing. Timberwolves shooting a smooth 58% from the field. Everything going according to plan for them on that end. And Bates Diop gets it to go.
And that's a great piece of work to get to the hoop there. Just tore the D to shreds.
Trent. Rebound by Napier.
And that is a textbook example of how to defend your rim.
And you know, guys, I love his fight and grit on the interior. I mean, he never lets a shot go uncontested. Excellent activity and timing on the offensive glass. That's how you get extra possessions.
And you don't want to give up that kind of look too often.
Trent gets the bucket.
Really nice job moving the ball around that time, picking apart that defense.
For Minnesota, they've gone 2 of 4 from the field since we started the final quarter of play. Here's Napier. Portland grabs the miss. LeVissier's got 4 rebounds in this game. Here's Horde. Goes up high for the two-handed dunk.
Yeah, just solid work on the back end of that play.
Yep, you're right. Finished hard with 2 hands on that stuff.
Yeah, highly efficient. Nothing extra special there. just effective.
Down low, Noel. Good, and it's Napier with the assist that time.
Terrific accuracy on that pass. That's how you lead your teammate.
Pass to Brown. Fades away. Again, the Trailblazers good for two.
You know, next time he has that much space, he should just go straight up with it and leave the fadeaway at home. Park that fadeaway. Take the shot that's available.
And Jang gets it to go.
And I like that they're not settling. Getting the ball on the interior, 8 of their last 10 coming that way.
Sometimes you just got to man up and take a tough foul in order to stop these free runs to the rim.
And just about 3 minutes through the fourth quarter here, the Timberwolves have gone 4 of 7 from the field since the beginning of the fourth. Here's Bates Diop, and he comes up with the deuce.
Not much resistance from the defense. Easy play that time for him.
The Trailblazers have gotten into a pretty good groove, going 6 of 10 here in the final quarter. Shots good by Horn. For Minnesota, they've gone 5 of 8 shooting as we've come down the home stretch in this final quarter. Three-pointer. It's hauled in by Brown. The Trailblazers have gone 7 of 11 from the floor in the final quarter so far. Been some solid looks for them.
Impressive, really, from that short 17 area. They are not missing many.
You're exactly right. I mean, they've banged home 8 of their last 10 points on mid-range jumpers.
Jang, no luck.
And not allowing the shooter even an inch of breathing room on that one.
And, guys, that's exactly the kind of high-impact defense they want to see out of him.
And he just elevates and powers in the one-hander.
Mm-hmm. Textbook.
I'm glad he didn't go overboard and try to do too much there.
To the inside. Yes, indeed, it is good. He's now 8 for 14.
I love the ball movement there. He put that on a silver platter. Just served him up.
Here's Horde. Here's Brown. Goes up and lays it nice and easy. Brown's got 6 points in the quarter.
And one of the stories of the second half has been all of those second chance points. I mean, they have been terrific on the offensive backboard.
Napier dishes to Bell. Nice ball movement by Minnesota. Jang, that's the 6th make from the field. He's taken 9 shots and missed but 3.
Yeah, the chemistry has been terrific. Really impressed with their offensive execution.
You know, the defense, Greg, has really been kept off balance because of the outstanding passes. 4 straight field goals have been made off an assist.
But for a while now, you and I were just talking. We've had a rule that a team cannot go without a first-round pick in consecutive years. Could it be time to lift that restriction?
I certainly wouldn't mind discussing lifting the restriction, but I like it as it is on the books because it does lend itself, I think, to competitive balance. And that's important in the strength of a league.
Now a timeout called by Portland.
Every timeout, a chance to review the lineups, matchups, or call a play.
And I agree. I think there's going to be a new wrinkle in their game plan when they come out of this timeout.
Here's Trent. From the baseline. And Portland again with the bucket.
And since halftime, he has been a different player.
And here's Napier. He'll bring it up for the Timberwolves. Passes it to Bates Diop. Over his own young. Bank shot. No good. Portland's gone 4 of 8 tonight from three-point land, shooting 50% on the three ball here. Again, the Trailblazers good for two.
Well, he's been a different player here in the second half, looking much more comfortable on the offensive end.
Pass to Jang. To the paint, Noel makes it off the glass.
And bullseye with that assist. Nice delivery there in traffic.
Time called here. The Blazers decide to talk it over. Clark, we hear a lot about the young basketball players in this country, the good ones playing in the AAU system. Is that the best way to develop talent for the NBA?
It's one of the better ways because the competition level is quite good across regions and throughout the country with these AAU teams. I think there's some great AAU programs and some tremendous benefits to participating in AAU basketball. Some things are better than others with it, but overall, I think it's pretty solid.
The Trailblazers shooting has been wild, 76%. That's just unbelievable. Minnesota's gone 1-3 from outside the arc since we've reached the fourth quarter. And it's off from three-point range. Here's Brown. That one's not going to go. So Minnesota will take it the other way. And he stuffs it. What a pass to set him up.
You gotta love his hustle, leaving the defense no time to react.
And you know you're gonna get those buckets, guys, when you're quick to get out on the break. Get that ball up the court as fast as you can.
And he's showing signs now of life after going scoreless through the half.
Fans are always trying to distract opposing players during free throws. Have you ever seen that work in an arena?
No, I think it's just a nice workout for the fans, Kevin, quite honestly. I mean, if a guy misses, it's not because the fans have gone crazy behind the basket. It's because he shot it left or right or short or long. It's not because of the fans being on top of him, at least in my opinion.
Right. You know, he was a non-factor in that first half, but now he's making up for lost time.
Jang, the pass to Bates Diop. The Timberwolves working the ball around now. Here's Napier. Tried to come right back with a three of his own, but it's no good. Here's Azania. A rebound by the Timberwolves. To the middle. And he takes it in for the layup off a very nice feed. Napier's got 13 points in the second half. Releases. And it's Horde missing. Minnesota's gone a disappointing 2-6 on three-point attempts here in the fourth. Noel, Hazonia defending. And there's the pass to Jang. To the inside, Bates Diop, and the layup's good off the glass. Bates Diop's got 6 points in the quarter.
Yeah, I love the communication and the chemistry between those teammates.
Out of bounds, Minnesota takes possession.
Boy, that looked like a failure to communicate. You hate unforced errors.
Simons, he's checked in for Hazania. The Timberwolves shooting 59% up to this point. They're working for great shots, and they're hitting them. Bates Diop, the pass to Napier. And it's Portland with the rebound. LeBissier's got 6 rebounds here tonight. Here's Trent. And that one's on target from the wing. Trent's got 21. Here's Napier. Last season, the NBA announcing the launch of a league in Africa, along with FIBA. Clark, what do you think of that move?
I think it's another example, Kevin, of the globalization of the game and the NBA's intentional, purposeful way of expanding and continuing to grow the game. For the sake of the business of basketball, which is a game that obviously you and I love.
And Clark, we see so many foreign players come into the NBA and play well. Not just play, but play well.
Yeah, and not just Africa, although a number of players from Africa, but a number of different countries have signed on. It could make for a more exciting league.
Brown, right side. Over Jang. And it's Brown missing. And for the Timberwolves, they're shooting 57% in this fourth quarter. Terrific assist, a nice finish, solid play all around.
Now that's where you like your shots to come from.
Labissiere, and he buries that one, drilling the rim on the way down.
And Labissiere has a really nice stroke. I mean, when he has his feet underneath him and is squared up, he's incredibly consistent from there.
Out to the wing, Noel. Off the mark there with the three-point shot. And Simons has got the ball here for Portland. And it's Horde missing. Here's Minnesota.
They need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
To the wing on the left. Fires from deep. Here's Jang. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
You know, guys, a better offensive player than many felt he would develop into, Jang attracts attention, draws the foul.
Well, as much as Gorgie Jang does on the court, he'll be remembered, Clark, by many for his off-the-court contributions.
Yeah, I agree wholeheartedly there. Jang has revamped hospitals in his home country of Senegal, as well as sent thousands upon thousands of meals back to his homeland. I mean, you can't say enough about what this man has done for others. And that really is a measure of influence, maturity, and leadership. Great, great impact being made by Jang off the court.
And he knocks down the first one. Clark, should the NBA consider widening the court to even out the value of those corner threes?
You know, that wouldn't be a bad idea, Kevin. But I also like the fact that there's a deep three at the top and on the wing. And then you've got a little shorter three if you can get to that corner. Widening the lane to make that three more in line or symmetrical with the deep three at the top. I kind of like having a short corner three.
I agree with you. The shot will not fall. And it's the Timberwolves taking it the other way.
Yes, and with this one winding down, it's obvious to everyone who watched it. Just a total mismatch and a true show of strength for the Trailblazers.
You don't see this kind of a blowout offense. But tonight, this is a quality win across the board to deliver out this kind of punishment.
They definitely never changed the approach. They just kept after it and showed they were clearly the better team in just about every single category.
And so this will mark the 15th win of the year for them. And you know, looking back at all the contributions tonight, it was a really phenomenal all-around game for Lillard.
Boy, this game really had his name all over it. I mean, he relished being the guy to carry the load offensively.
Assisted. Beautiful reverse jam right there.
Use the rim to protect the ball, I think.
Outstanding awareness and a terrific finish.
And you can sense that these fans, these players, they are ready to celebrate.
And I think they can start that celebration right now. I mean, what a terrific team victory.
Noel, that three off the mark.
Timeout, timeout.
You know, brick after brick after brick. I mean, that's been the story for him this quarter. I mean, he's got to rein it in down the stretch here.
Time called here. The Blazers decide to talk it over. They're ahead by 47. 43 seconds left to play here in the fourth. Presentation of our Jordan Player of the Game, Damian Lillard.
And it's been a ridiculous performance in the best sense possible. I mean, everything about his game has been working. And no matter what they've thrown at him, he's had the answer.
The better he played, the more these fans got revved up. And that continued to play out over the course of his amazing performance. From deep, rebound by Jang.
A shot like that is a polite way to say, hey, coach, bench me.
Hey, that's crazy there. I mean, insanity. At least wait until you get across half court. My goodness.
About 7 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. Here's Simons. Portland, no good that time either.
And that was a little bit of a range check for him.
You know, guys, I think he's got confidence to shoot it from anywhere, but he could have gotten a better one than that.
Excellent pass there to cap that break with an uncontested basket.
And so Portland takes this one, but by a big margin. It was a tale of two teams tonight, one that was in total control, operating flawlessly, and the other just searching for answers that they could never find.
I mean, the energy here is just so tremendous. Fans involved from the get-go, and once they started to really pour it on, it was fun to see that rhythm and flow from their perspective.
And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Thank you, Kevin. With Damian Lillard, Dame, you guys seem to be in a good groove right now. How do you keep the momentum going?
You take it one game at a time. You got to remember what makes you a successful basketball team, and that's us moving the ball, get up and down, and defend. And we've been able to do that.
It has all come together for you, Dame. Hope it keeps going. Thanks. Kevin, back to you.
All right, David, thank you. And that'll do it, folks. For Greg Anthony, Clark Kellogg, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan. Thanks for watching this presentation of the NBA on 2K Sports. See you next time.